Hello everyone. Today we will be concentrating on one of the important concepts of microcontroller lab using Keil software. I'm your friend Madhavesh Khanderao, assistant professor, Department of ENC, Gosia College of Engineering, Ramnagaram. We'll be concentrating today on hands-on experience on Keil software for the microcontroller lab. Now let us see the practical session of the Keil software. Double click on the Keil software, what we have it on the desktop. So you can see that a new window gets open of a Keil software. Okay, now you can find here a three windows. One is project workspace, another one is output window, the third one is the program where we write it. So here project workspace means the project what we are doing it, it will be displayed it here. And the output window is where we get error information of the program when we compile it. The third, there's one more window, the fourth window about the simulation when we get it after the compilation of the program there. Now, first let us create a project of what we want to do here. Okay, first let us create a project. Go to the project icon here, click new project. Okay, a my document window gets open. So let us create one folder here. Okay, with the name microcontroller lab, MC lab. Okay. So this is the folder I'm just creating it. So click this and open it. So MC lab. Now in this, we can create a project. So MC lab. MC lab is the project name what I am just creating it here. So click save. So one more window gets open here where we have to select the particular microcontroller what we have. Okay. So here we have a Philips IC in our lab. So let's go to that particular IC what we have it in our lab. So that is 8X5C51RD+. So select this. So it gives 8051 microcontroller has been selected. So click OK. So it says that copy standard 8051 startup code to a project folder here and add files to the projects. So once we click S, so here you can observe a startup.a51 program gets uploaded it here. So this is the standard library which gets added to the target file what we have to create it. So now we have to write the program. For writing the program, go to the file, click new. As I said, in this window, we have to write the program. So you can observe text editor window. Okay. In this editor window, we have to write the program. Okay, I already written the program for the data transfer from one memory location to the another memory location using the assembly language. As we know that microcontroller, we are writing with the help of a 8051 assembly language here. Okay, so first we can observe the program. I will explain you the program while executing. So originate starting address. Okay, first let us save this program. Save. So you can observe the same folder gets open here. Here I'm writing program of data transfer. .asm is very important because this is an assembly language program. Okay, save. So you can observe the keywords gets colored. So now we have to add the file to this particular target file. Add a file. Okay, so what is that file is program. Okay, go to the .asm. So you can observe program.asm. Click this add. So here program for the data transfer.asm is getting added. Okay, now we have to compile this one. Okay, after compiling, rebuild it as we can just check it out. Here, there is no error in the program. Okay, so now let us check this program is executing properly or not, that the algorithm is working properly or not. Go to the debug, start and stop. So you can observe that new window gets open here, simulation window. So memory one, let us take it as X:. So you can observe in the program originate starting address of the program is 00H, and you can observe data pointer of the higher byte is 80H. And we have taken the source address as 35. There is 8035 as a source address. So we can write this here 8035H. Press enter. The memory locations of the 8035H gets open. You can observe previously the data are zero. Okay. So I'll just give the data as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in the source data, I'm giving the data. So you can observe in the source data, data is getting modified. Okay. Similarly, what is destination address is R1, which is 45. That is, I'll use this memory 2 as a destination address X:. 8045H. So when I enter this, you can observe the destination data. There is all zeros previously. Okay. How many data is 5? As we already given 5 data here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So now we have to see whether this program is working properly or not. The concepts, there is the algorithm. Okay. So here, just above the project workspace, above, we can see a step information, step into, that is single step execution. So the arrow mark is at 2. If I click this execution here, you can observe DPH will become 80. Where is DPH data pointer? This 2 byte become 80H. Right click. So you can observe 80H. So now R0 is 35. So you can observe R0 register, it become 35. R1 will become 45 and R3 will become 5. So source address, destination address and 5 data. Now algorithm is in this particular loop. So from R0, it should go to DPL. What is R0 35? So execute it. So you can observe 8035. It has become a source address. So MOVX A comma at DPTR. So external memory, when we are transferring it, we are writing it as X. So MOVX A comma at. It's a data present in this particular memory location, 8035H. 8035 is 1. So from 8035, accumulator gets 1. You can observe here. So 1 accumulator has been updated. So from R1, R1 is destination address. That comes to the DPTR. And from accumulator, it goes to the DPTR. That is the external memory. Now let us go to the destination memory. You can observe here. When destination memory, it is 0. Once I click this execution, you can observe here the data gets modified. So click. So you can observe that from the accumulator, it is indirectly going to the memory location of 8045H. And increment the pointer of source, that is R0. 35 become 36, 45 become 46. Decrement jump if it is not equal to 0, that is R3. Decrement R3. And if it is not equal to 0, go to the back location, jump. So R3 is 4, so it is going back. And the operation gets repeated. Okay, so now again, you can observe R0 will go to DPL. So what is that DPL? You can observe that DPL is, so first let us click on this. So R0 is 46, 36. So from 36, it goes to the DPL. Again, click on this, so from DPL, accumulator gets updated with second value, that is 2. Run. So destination is become 46. Next, you can observe in destination, second data has been updated. So click next. Source address is incremented. Click next. Destination address is incremented. It decrements R3 now in this. So it has become 3 and go back. So this process is repeated. So you can observe the all data gets transferred. Okay, so 3, 4, 5. Okay, so all the data have been transferred now. Now you observe the R3 value, it is 1. Okay. Okay, now decrement jump if it is not equal to 0. Okay, so once it decrements, this will become 0. It means it should come outside the loop. So it will come to the next stage. You can observe here. You can observe it has become 0. So it has come to the next location. So here jump, okay, it is repeating to the infinite loop there. Okay, so if you keep on running, it will be in the same state. So this is the program for the data transfer from one memory location to the another memory location here. Okay, so in this way we can easily write the program in the Keel software for the microcontroller program in the assembly language. I hope you like this video and understood the concepts of the data transfer program using Keel software. If you have any question, go to the comment section and write down your question. I reply to your question. If you like this video, share this video along with your friends just to gain their information. If you like this video, subscribe to my channel. Click on the bell icon for further notification. Thank you.